You see all these different plants right here in a row? The heat has been here, the moisture's been here. Obviously, when you do like that and you scratch down, that's moist, you know, and the first 24 hours when you put cotton into the ground, it imbibes that moisture, and then it starts to generate its shoot and comes alive. We typically try to put on about 43,500 seed per acre. Cotton loves heat. It loves sunlight, but it does have like a little bit of moisture. It can stand a little drought tolerance built into it. Nothing beats planting a crop, getting it in on time, watching it grow, keeping it clean, keeping it nurtured all throughout the year, and then the harvest. That's actually what excites me, the harvest. If you have a good yield on a great crop, there's nothing better, honestly. My brother John and myself, we farm around 2,700 acres of cotton, peanuts, and soybeans. We try to do a lot of cool things with our farm. We're fourth and fifth generation farmers, so a lot's expected out of us, I guess you would say. It's something we were brought up with. Yeah, we love agriculture, and that's why we're here every day.
Cotton remains an important crop in North Carolina's farm economy. There are roughly 1,400 cotton farms statewide, growing almost 500,000 acres, producing almost $1 billion in revenue. And while the challenges facing cotton farmers like the Flemings remain,
the hard things about it is Mother Nature, hurricanes, that type of thing. That's the kind of the curveball that you get thrown every once in a while.
Science is transforming the entire cotton industry.
Science is everything now. It starts off with seed.
So there's different possibilities of cotton plants here.
So we work on a different project for different traits.
Could you eventually genetically change the plant enough that you've got the optimum seed for fiber and food and oil?
Yes, we can.
You could change all that eventually?
Yes, eventually we can combine them together to make the perfect plant.
Researchers at East Carolina University were the first to apply gene editing technology on cotton seeds. It's an effort to create a cotton plant with the best traits.
It's fun to do the preliminary work too, but because it's going to lead to something much greater, like stronger cotton.
Scientists want to learn which genes shape how the plant produces the fibers for clothing, the oil in cotton seeds, or the plant's tolerance to extreme heat and drought and pests. If scientists can pinpoint which genes affect specific traits, it could produce better seeds and higher crop yields.
This usually when cotton get a flower like this. When get the flower, then get the young cotton ball, then get the big cotton ball, then finally will be getting.
So seed and variety selection is important because, you know, some varieties do better in certain climates, some do better in others. And what you want to do as a farm manager or a farmer is you want to know the characteristics of that particular variety, and you want to understand the characteristics of the soil that you have on your farm. You want to match the variety with the land that you're managing.
Well, saying it easily, it starts with science. Fashion is that someone likes a color, or someone likes how something looks on them, or how it feels on them. So it's a combination of subjective and objective, and then putting those together, and then making them work.
Cotton Incorporated is the research arm of the entire cotton industry. Growers and importers fund Cotton Incorporated. The labs are in Cary. Researchers work to improve every link in the cotton supply chain.
You start with a cotton fiber, you put it together in a yarn, then you compose a fabric, and you want it to have certain functionality. And we think that's the coolest thing ever. Oh, this fabric has breathability. Look at it, has less air permeability. Oh, it's very, very soft. We have to marry that science behind that functionality with something that the consumer would want to buy.
So this is cotton.
It is 100% cotton.
And it's been dyed, correct?
It's been dyed with indigo.
Okay.
That's right.
All right.
So it's an indigo knit, so indigo yarn, and it's done in knits, and it's also done on your denim. And a laser machine will, with the intensity and time, can etch away different amounts of the indigo color from the fabric to create these gradations. All our efforts are towards more sustainable ways to do things, and one is laser technology, which is a very interesting and cool technology.
It's beyond just creating whisker wash looks, you can also laser etch photorealistic patterns on denim as well. You could have a picture of your pet cat.
And now this is your skin.
And remember how cotton loves water? Well, researchers have developed a cotton weave that transports water through the fabric. It's used in athletic wear to wick perspiration away from your skin. There's also now a cotton that repels water,
but keeps it still soft and also still breathable. And you can drop water on them.
This is a sweatshirt fabric.
Okay. So we have a fleece here, which would go into a sweatshirt.
Okay.
This is called storm denim because it's the storm treatment on a denim. And so the water just beads on top, and that keeps you from getting drenched.
It's all to grow an industry and a plant.
When you're sitting in that cotton pick at the end of the day, and you're picking a heck of a crop, it generates a smile on your face every time.